The construction of a new Philippine Senate building suspended by the Senate President due to a significant budget overrun. Senator Francis Escudero ordered a review of the project after its construction cost more than double to 23 billion pesos in June 2024. The initial budget was 8.9 billion pesos, but the former Senate Accounts Committee Chairperson Panfilo Lacson justifies the additional cost. Lacson says it factors in the huge increase in land value in Bonifacio Global City. For Lacson's successor, Senator Nancy Binay, Escudero should have spoken to her about the project instead of relying on gossip mongers. Binay says Escudero's decision to suspend the construction could lead to more expenses. But she agrees with the Senate President that costs must be brought down. Turning now to the crackdown on Pampanga's biggest pogo hub, a document released by gaming regulator PAGCOR shows Lucky South 99 had no license to operate. PAGCOR also disclosed reports of the pogo's involvement in illegal activities as well as its possible connection with the raided illegal pogo compound in Bamban, Tarlac. Authorities have been searching the Porak pogo compound where they discovered evidence of torture and scam activities. Aside from gadgets and cash, they also seized more than a dozen adult toys, which they suspect were used for sex trafficking.
Pag na hindi nila na-meet yung quotas nila, so talagang yun ang ginagamit sa kanila. No? Kasi report, accordingly, sa report, kinukunan ng pictures, videos, tapos ibibenta parang gano'n. Tapos, ginagawa din silang parang prostitute dito.
As of Monday, authorities have searched half of the more than 40 buildings in the compound. Another possible threat rising in the South China Sea. U.S. think tank Asia Maritime Transparency Initiative reveals Vietnam is ramping up its island-building activity in Spratly Islands, part of which is being claimed by the Philippines. From 138 in 2022, Hanoi has already created 280 new hectares of land on the island so far this year. But a maritime expert believes Manila's maritime row with Beijing overshadows Vietnam's actions.
Vietnam is facing a possibly even greater threat from China, no, pagdating dun sa mga isla na yon. Meron daw actual threat ang China na titirahin nila yung Vietnam in relation to yung petroleum exploration nila. We're concerned dahil syempre may effect yun din yun dun sa natural environment. Pero at least pagdating dun sa mga ganyang issue, nakita natin hindi ginagawa ng Vietnam yung ginagawa ng China sa atin.
Jay Batong Bakal adds, despite Vietnam's suspicious move, there is no need for Manila to file a case against Hanoi.
Maayos yung relationship ng dalawang bansa eh. So parang there's no real reason to undertake any legal action na adversarial. Dahil nakakapag-usap pa sila, di nandun yung pag-asa.
The Philippine Coast Guard, for its part, does not see Vietnam as a threat. It asserts Hanoi is not harassing Filipino fishermen on the island and is only reclaiming features they initially occupied. Both the Philippines and Vietnam have overlapping claims in the South China Sea, but the two maintained good relations. Philippine House Deputy Majority Leader Erwin Tulfo wants the United Nations General Assembly to intervene in the West Philippine Sea issue. He filed a resolution Monday urging the Foreign Affairs Department to raise China's unlawful actions before the UNGA. Tulfo notes Beijing continues to go against the Hague Court's arbitration ruling invalidating its expansion claims in the South China Sea. The House leader believes a UN resolution on the matter could help Manila assert its maritime rights and seek global support against unlawful actions by any state. The Philippine government denying the release of expelled lawmaker Arnolfo Teves Jr. from detention in Timor-Leste. Justice Assistant Secretary Mico Clavano clarifies Teves was released and subsequently rearrested to stand trial for his extradition case. He also took a swipe at the lawyer of Teves, attorney Ferdinand Tobacco, saying he made misleading and highly irresponsible statements about his client's release. On Monday, Tobacco shared a photo of him and Tevez, saying he was released from jail pending his extradition trial. The DOJ now says it is confident the extradition proceedings against Tevez will be successful. But Clavano notes the deportation route to bring back Tevez to the Philippines is still on the table. As for the camp of Tevez, Attorney Tobacco insists his client was released from prison. Tobacco claims Tevez was freed from detention at the Bicora prison after the Philippine government did not follow correct procedures. He also says it is the DOJ that keeps on issuing misleading statements about Tevez and his case. Tevez is facing multiple murder charges for the March 2023 killing of Negros Oriental Governor Ruel Degamo and nine others. He was arrested in Timor-Leste back in March while playing golf. The followers of fugitive televangelist Apollo Quiboloy tried to prevent authorities from serving arrest warrants from him in Davao City. Arnel Tokmo reports.
Members of CIDG, Special Action Force, Police Regional Office 11, and policemen from neighboring regions stormed several properties of Kingdom of Jesus Christ leader Apollo Quiboloy. This is to serve the warrants of arrest against the pastor as well as to five co-accused for charges of child abuse, sexual abuse, and human trafficking. But entering the premises of KOJC compound in Buhangin, Davao City was not easy as KOJC members guarded the areas. The members expressed anger towards the members of police and media.
Ito talagang makikita natin na oppression talaga, no? Talagang harassment yung ginagawa ng gobyerno. Alam naman namin sa side ng pulis na ginagawa lang nila yung tungkulin nila kasi merong talaga umuutos sa kanila.
This lady, who is a KOJC college scholar, reported that she was injured by the police who forcibly entered the gate, but she said it was not intentional. Choppers of PNP also flew over the compound. Videos provided by Quiboloy's legal counsel, attorney Israelito Torion, showed some of the policemen looking for his client. Inside the compound, including the rooms and offices, as well as the hangar, where a chopper and a private plane were found. Around 8 in the morning, policemen left the compound, unable to find Quiboloy. Law enforcers also went to the Prayer Mountain and Glory Mountain in Barangay Tamayung.
Gusto natin i-emphasize na part ng criminal law procedures, officers can break into premises or building or enclosure in serving the warrant of arrest.
Delaray said the camp of Quiboloy noticed the operation before they implemented the warrant of arrest.
As much as ginagawa naman natin na magiging smooth yung operation, pero hindi naman po kasi natin kontrolado lahat ng mga information and knowledge, hindi natin alam. Pero ang aim natin is magiging peaceful yung pag-serve natin ng warrant of arrest.
According to PNP spokesperson Colonel Jean Fajardo, they received information that led to the implementation of arrest warrants.
Sana po ay sumuko na po sila. I think yung courts po ay yun po yung proper venue para sagutin po itong mga reklamong isinampa po sa kanila.
Senate President Francis Escudero said the arrest order of the Senate against Quiboloy is still in effect.
Marahil unang may implement yon kung sakasakali. At matapos niyan, doon na lang magre-request. Kung ma-implement na yung warrant of arrest galing sa korte, doon na lamang siguro magre-request si Senator Risa o ang Senado na dalhin dito si Pastor Quiboloy para mag-attend ng pagdinig. Priority pa rin yung criminal case palagi.
The PNP asserts manhunt operations against Quiboloy will continue. Hernel Tokmo, ABS-CBN News.
Let's now get an update on the weather from Pagasa forecaster Glyza Esculiar. Hi, Glyza.
Hello, Bettina, and this is the latest on the weather. At 3 a.m. today, the low pressure area being monitored by Pagasa was spotted at 145 kilometers west-northwest of Butuan City, Agusan del Norte, or over the coastal waters of Bohol. This weather system will bring cloudy skies with scattered rain showers and thunderstorms over eastern Visayas, Dinagat Islands, Rigao del Norte, and Agusan del Norte. Flash floods or landslides are possible over these areas during moderate to at times heavy rains. This low pressure area, however, is not expected to develop into a bagyo or a tropical depression, but will weaken or dissipate within the next 24 to 36 hours. Meanwhile, Metro Manila and the rest of the country will have partly cloudy to cloudy skies with isolated rain showers or thunderstorms in the afternoon or early evening. The temperature range for Metro Manila will be between 25 to 33 degrees Celsius, and the highest heat index is expected to be at 44 degrees Celsius over Tuguegarao City, Dagupan City, and Roja City. This is Clarissa Escolar from the Pag-asa Weather Forecasting Section. Reporting.
Thank you very much for that update, Glyza.